this is a trade that people think is just a trade for survival, which is not true. It is a trade that can change the nation.
These guys have kind of like forgotten men. There's a lot of these guys that get into construction that don't realize that anybody even cares about them. A lot of the ministries themselves don't realize that there's even a ministry for these men. They're kind of forgotten men. And they get out there, some of the roughest guys you'll ever meet, some of them that get into construction because they don't think there's any other place for them. And actually that's kind of a condition that tends to be worldwide. A lot of guys get into construction because they think, well, there's nothing else for me, so I might as well swing a hammer.
This trade is filled with people from all walks of life. It is easy to get people who, for example, did not go to school and have gone through all sorts of life. Some have been robbers, some have been murderers, some have been through different kinds of lives that are not socially acceptable. So when you get them here to the site, they come with an aim of making money so they can survive. They can take some food home and they can clothe their children and take them to school. That is all they come that is what they come with on their minds. But when they get here, the most important thing that I realized with EMI is that they get to know Christ.
These guys will actually do better if I start making them realize they're more important than the buildings we're building. What turned into, we need to get these buildings built properly, turned into, we need to start developing these men and making them realize that God really loves them, who they are, exactly who they are, and wants to see them grow as husbands and fathers and men in their societies, as leaders in their society, so that they're not just swinging a hammer, they're actually serving God with their hands. Basically what EMI is, it's been around for about 25 years, actually 26 years now. They've discovered that while we're really strong with helping partnering ministries develop master plans and fundraising documents, and in many cases there's been a disconnect between the actual buildings we design and what's actually being constructed. We started realizing that maybe we need to put construction managers from the West on the construction sites so that we can oversee and make sure that what we've designed is being built.
Richard Tatiabala, and I'm doing civil and building construction Uganda. And I've been working in this trade for more than 10 years now. What EMI is doing right now is also teaching us to be very faithful at the places of our work, in such a way that what you do matters. EMI is bringing a lot of love in the people while they're at work, to let the people know that it's all about God and how you serve God matters. You don't need to be to the pulpit to serve God. You don't need to be at the church to serve God, but you can also be working right here and serving God.